Okay. And then if you don't mind starting the timer.
Right now?
Yep. Welcome to class, everyone. Today we are going to start with a warm-up called What Are You Doing? So I need all the students to get into two lines, single file. One line is going to be right here, one line is going to be right here, and you guys are going to be facing each other, all right? So everyone come on up. All right, the way that you play this game is the person in this line starts pantomiming an action, and say my action is brushing my teeth, and so I'm brushing my teeth, and the person in this other line facing them asks the question, what are you doing? And the person who is pantomiming then says anything other than what the action that they're doing. So I'm brushing my teeth and I say, I'm washing a car. And the person on this other side starts pantomiming washing a car. Then the person who was doing the action goes to the back of the line, and the next person asks the question, what are you doing? Person pantomiming says an action, anything that they are not doing, and we continue until we go through everyone. All right, so here we go. Go. Here's our warm up. Wonderful. Okay. Now let's have everyone come to the circle, go back to your desks, whatever the class is like with the furniture. And so let's have everyone go back to their desks now. All right. Okay. Now tell me, what was difficult about that activity and maybe what was easy about that activity? Thank you. Yes, I agree. Wonderful. All right, now let's think about this activity a little bit further as well. And tell me, how can we make connections from this activity to our everyday lives? For example, people may think that we're doing some kind of action, and then we actually say that we're doing something else, right? Any thoughts? Blah, 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 blah. Stereotypes? What? Oh, thank you for that suggestion. So stereotypes can be that way where, everyone thinks that we're doing one thing and we're actually doing something else. And, there's often these inner and outer, portrayals of an individual, right? Thank you. Okay, now let's go ahead and pull up this image on my giant screen that I have in my classroom. Wonderful. Now, oh, it blacked out. Okay, now this is an image of Cinderella, right? Okay, now tell me, what things do you know about Cinderella? Please answer.
She talks to animals.
She talks to animals. Okay, what else do you know about her?
She had to clean the house all the time.
She did a lot of cleaning, correct. What kind of relationships did she have in her life?
Really bad relationships.
With who?
Her stepsisters and stepmom.
That's true. Did she have any good relationships in her life?
Fairy godmother?
The fairy godmother would be a good relationship, yes. Anything else that we know about Cinderella?
The glass slipper.
The glass slipper? What about the glass slipper?
It fit on her foot.
It did fit. And then she was able to marry the prince and everything like that, right? Yes. Okay. Can you tell anything from what Cinderella is wearing?
It looks like she's got lots of money.
It does look like she has a lot of money. Is that, knowing what we know about Cinderella, is that a little deceptive?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Why is that?
Because she's really poor, or at least her stepmom treated her like a slave.
Right. Yeah. She actually has no money to her name, right? This is just another example of, you know, that outer portrayal that we might have can be very different from what is actually, like, the reality of life. And so what we just did, kind of, is script analysis or character analysis. So if you knew the facts about Cinderella based off of maybe a movie that you saw, or maybe you read a book, or friends and family told you about Cinderella, right? And so looking at the details of the story, you were able to come up with all of these facts about Cinderella, right? And so we do that in theater with scripts and with shows and everything like that, where we're able to look at the finer details of the script to be able to create a bigger picture of individual characters and such. And so, so does anyone have like a general definition, is the word I'm looking for, of character analysis? It's where you look at the finer details of the character using the script. Thank you.
That's what I said.
Thank you so much. How do you find those little details? Well, you look at the text. Good, you're very familiar with the text. Maybe you do a character background. Thank you. A character background is looking at the backstory of the character. How did they get to the point that they're at now? What makes them them? Are they an only child? Are they one of many children? What's their backstory? Maybe look at relationships that they have. Yes, thank you. Yes, definitely look at the relationships that they have. Are they angry with their parents? Or do they have a loving family? Are they outcast in school?
Check to see how other people have portrayed the character.
Right. You could definitely look at other productions of things as well and get some ideas going, because the great thing about character analysis is that you can find a lot of facts in the script, but also there's a lot of ways that you can read in between the lines as you use those facts. And so today we're going to be looking at character analysis with the characters that you researched before coming to class today. As you know, we've been using the novel Speak, and as we just finished that novel, we're going to go into more details. We're going to go into more details of individual characters, right? And so we had a group of you who looked at the parents or the antagonist, the protagonist, the names that are escaping my brain right now. Yes. And so let's go ahead. We're going to share what we found with our peers. So I'm going to split you into groups of 3 to 4. It doesn't matter if you have the same characters or different characters from your group. Hopefully you have different characters. And so we're going to have you guys go together. We're going to have you guys go together and you guys go together. And in your groups, go ahead and share the 3 images that you researched and why you thought these images portrayed the characters. Okay, go ahead. Wonderful. You have about 5 minutes. Great. Okay, wonderful. Thank you so much. Okay, now, everyone, you're going to go into specific character groups now. So we have all of the moms over here, all of the dads over here, yada yada, blah blah blah. Okay, now that you are in your character groups, I want all of you to think of a belief statement for your character. So what motivates your character to do the things that they do? What is a strong belief that your character has? Just how can you embody your character in a sentence, essentially? All right? So go ahead. You have a few minutes to come up with that. Do you have a question?
I have my belief statement.
Oh, you have your belief statement? Wonderful. Belief statements. Okay. Now, we're going to go even further from our belief statements and the pictures that you were able to research, and you, every group is going to create a character belief board. Okay? So, within this belief board, you need to have 6 images that describe the inner workings of your character, your inner beliefs. So this can be insecurities, this can be how your character really feels. You have 6 images for the outer portrayal of your character. So maybe what your character looks like, maybe the stereotypes that your character fits under or tries to act under, and things like that. And then 6 power statements about your character. So these are one word statements that describe your character. And really think about, if you were to boil down your character, what are 6 words that would purely describe them, right? Okay, now you're going to look up these images on your phone, your laptop, go through Google, go through Pinterest, maybe find some things off of Instagram by searching through some hashtags. But this is your chance to be creative and really depict the character with their inner and their outer workings, right? And so once you have your images collected and your statements thought through, then you're going to compile it into a belief board. Now you have a variety of ways that you can display your belief board. You can do it through a series of pins on Pinterest. You will need to make sure that the descriptions on the pictures actually go with the character rather than simply repinning things. You can create a Finsta for your character, and so the picture that you post could be their outer thoughts, and then maybe some of the statement words could be in the descriptions of the pictures. You could do it through a PowerPoint, you could do it through a collage, or if you have any other ideas, just come and clear it with me. You have about 15-20 minutes to research. If you don't have a smartphone, partner with someone who does, and make sure that everyone is truly involved in creating this belief board, and make sure that you're justifying your answers with your peers as well. All right, so go ahead and do this belief board. Great. Okay, your time is up. Wonderful. Now we're gonna share our belief boards, okay? So go ahead, let's have someone come up and share their board. Thank you so much. Does everyone agree with the images and statements? Why or why not? let's use I wonder, I love, I noticed in your comments. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All right, now, just remember that character analysis is crucial for, script analysis is crucial for character analysis, which can justify all of your production needs with design, with performance, with everything like that. Thank you.